see how the color kind of resembles each other. I don't know. That was a skeeter.
Oh. That is cool. Hey guys, so before foremost, I lost my voice this morning, so if you can barely hear me or my voice sounds a little deep or different, that's why. But anyways, my dad pulled off good on this truck. I mean, he did clear coat. Sadly, I did not record him doing the clear coat. I was out of town this morning, went to grab a couple of things from the next town over. But wow, my old man pulled it off. Look at that. I know there's a couple of dents here and there, especially on top of the roof. I'll show you in a moment, but just look at that. And then this taped it off. It's gonna be black, and this is still gonna be painted to this color. So the chrome, this is basically the chrome part. The most of the chrome was peeled off. Finished peeling it off, and then sand it, and then this is gonna stay the same color as the middle of the cab. So, and then there's that one dent here. But anyways, let me show you them dents up here. That indicated me that there's been some hail damage on this truck. Oh, you see it now? Yeah, and then there's this weird line that's going across. But, I mean, it is what it is. There was no paint on top of the cab when I started sanding, so. Hey, just look at that. And yes, I'm also rocking that Mack truck t-shirt right now. But just, wow. I mean, it's not completely perfect, you know. I can see a little bit of orange peel, that's what that is. But, man, for what it is, what's going to be used for, it's going to be all right. Let's see what happened here. But I was like, oh no, that's just tape. I hope that's tape. I hope my dad taped this off. I mean, that's what it looks like, I think. It is what it is, right? I mean, anyways, wow. Thing is good, it's shiny. So if you're wondering how do you do this, you know, on your damn project that you've been doing for the past 8 years, I'm playing, but this can be done on the cheap. Just get yourself a good air compressor. We have a giant one. Get you some air hoses and everything. Well, actually, from air compressor and everything that is required, like the sander, the paint gun, all that, Harbor Freight. And a matter of fact, Harbor Freight, you ought to sponsor me, because I do a lot of stuff with y'all stuff. But paint gun, the sandpaper, the sander, except for the paint. But everything is Harbor Freight that we use to do this. No problems. The air compressor, we got that actually with the shop, I think. I can't remember now, but the air compressor is a big, giant one. It's one of those good industrial ones. But let's just say that it just turned out real good. Paint, we had leftover paint from the project truck that I sold. Brunette, I named her Brunette, her too. It's the truck that's in the profile picture of this channel. We only had half a gallon left, which it finished it all. I mean, so if we had the bed on still, it would not have made it. So. Yep, but the paint at the time cost nearly $350. It's a gallon. It's acrylic enamel. They do sell paint specifically to be mixed with the clear coat, but we did a different route because since we had the paint left over, we just bought clear coat. This is the end result. So if it was paint that was made to be used with the clear coat, and all that. I don't know if it's cheaper or more expensive. I think it's more expensive. It would look a little bit more different, but with that clear coat, man. As long as you keep it clean, waxed and all that, make sure it's all, you know, clear coat's still intact. That shininess is gonna be there for a long time. And the acrylic enamel will fade away with the sunlight if you don't wax it. Buff it, I mean, really. Or both, technically. But, man, I'm just loving this. There's a few, you know, hiccups. Like, there's a run right there and up here, too. But who am I to judge? I mean, I'm a fucking old man. He did pretty good, man. He did pretty good. Look, here's even the cab. Look at the grill corner there. It goes right here. Yeah. So I'm going to let this drive for a day. But now we got to kick off and kind of start, you know, grinding gears because I need to put back, I need to install the cab lights, horns, air hoses, and all that up here. Get it done. I need to get on Monday the lady here in town who does upholstery. She can do my headliner, my sun visors. I managed to get some sun visors off of the one of the parts trucks out there. Same color, tan. What I do plan to do in the back here in the sleeper area, is going to put some insulation on the floor, then build the bed, and then here on the panels, we're not going to put back the plastic because the plastic, you know, it takes literally like 2-3 inches of space. So we're going to just leave it like this, and that gets me 2-3 inches of space. So we're going to use that cardboard deal that we used on the white, the Volvo, when we painted it over there. Over there, you see that cardboard that's laying on top of the the 18-wheeler tires over there? It's a big piece of like pressed cardboard or whatever. That's what we used to do the headliner for the Volvo. But, or the white, I should say. So I'm gonna try to get some material like diamond shaped, you know, vinyl to do, you know, the sides and then the last part on top because it's gonna be the regular fabric, canliner fabric and the sun visors. It'll be nice to do it all together, but I want a little bit more contrast and all the same. It's continuous the same and, you know, it's kind of, to me, it just doesn't look right. And have a little mix match. Of deal back here look good, you know. So I need to buy some. I might buy some regardless because I do want to do that because the panels I'm gonna cut them into shape. I'll just have to get some measurements off the plastic parts because I'm not trying to guess whatever those measurements are. If I got the plastic, well, I took them to the tool room, but the plastics, for instance, like that. Measure it, cut it out, and slap on that vinyl stuff, and boom, self-tap it to the the cab. So, yeah, it's plenty of work still to do, but we knocked out the big major stuff. I do need to get me another bumper, though, because this bumper is just banged the hell off. It's all crooked and stuff. It won't look right. What I might do is might take it off to see how it looks. And might just install like a panel here with the two tail lights, you know, just for now. But legally, I do need to get some fender covers here for the wheels. So I might just do an 18-wheeler special, you know, get a bracket and put like a fender there, quarter fender, whatever. So the mud doesn't sling up forward, but it's still gonna sling up forward. I know there's ones that they sell for the hotshot trucks, but I don't know how much those are. And if they're expensive, I do not want to buy one because there's no point. Hopefully in the future, I extend some extra frame, build me a second axle, you know, like a dummy or a weight axle so it looks tandem and get rid of this stupid exhaust. Because I want to do it like a single pipe out, you know, but... For now, just for time's sake, we're just going to polish it, look, make it look good. Just get another bumper, maybe. Or just leave that bumper. I mean, I would like to make it look nice, but options are kind of limited. So, them tail lights. I wonder how I'm gonna set them up though, to be honest with you. But we will see. Yeah, we will see about that. Or hell, I'll just take it off and get some channel iron and just bolt it up to there. Don't have to weld anything. I don't want to weld nothing. Just put it there and whatnot. But we'll see. Hell, might even do what they do on the big rigs too. Put a piece of, I guess, angle iron with the lights right here. Three little LED lights. And then one reverse light. One big LED bar for the reverse light, you know. But we will see. It's just a matter of what the hell to do and how much money to spend or how much I'm willing to spend. But, man, this looks nice. Big stuff is now done. It's just small little things that we need to do. But, yeah. So I'm going to just wrap this up quickly. Man, if I would... It's just wow. But anyways, if y'all do go to the truck show in Houston, it's called Trucks in Houston for some odd reason. It's Texas Truck Market, I think that's what it is. I'll leave the link down in the description below. Go get tickets. They're free for the general admission, you know, to get in, you know, to you visit, whatever. It's free. Don't have to pay nothing. But if you want to bring your truck, like me, you got to pay some money. It is not expensive. It's relatively cheap. So I already registered mine. Or I registered already. So I'll see y'all October 15th. And I know there's a few YouTubers that are truck drivers and stuff that are going to that show. I would like to see them, see their trucks. And then when they see mine, you know, quick little shout outs, whatever. Get people to subscribe to my channel too, because they'll see how I built this. Because I guarantee you, when people are going to go over there, or I go over there, they're going to be like, how the hell? You know, they're going to be like, what the hell, basically. It's never seen something like this, honestly. I mean, there's only a few people who do the tilt-tilt deal, but they haven't seen a truck custom to a, you know, a semi, you know, big rig. And it's a Chevrolet. Like I said, I based it off the Chevy Bison, but it's not exactly, though, because, you know, the hood didn't work with the fiberglass. But, I mean... It's still gonna work. Does the job, you know, as long as the function works. So, yeah. So let me just quickly wrap this up. Subscribe, hit the notification bell so y'all know when I upload. Like and comment. You already know what to do. And I appreciate it, guys. Thank you. So I'll catch you on the flip side.